and damp and moist soil. They are grown in that moist soil. Okay, so that is known as that Markensia. In this Markensia, plant body is made up of parenchyma tissue, right? So at that ventral side, so it means vegetative organs are present. So that is the reproductive organs are present. At the dorsal side, so unicellular rhizoids are present. By the rhizoids, Markensia is attached to that substratum. Okay, so after that, generally Markensia is a dioecious plant. Male plant and female plant are that okay different. For example, so in the reproduction process, okay, generally they are producing of that. So it means visited reproduction is takes place by that reproduction process. Reproduction process, visited reproduction process takes place by fragmentation and multicellular green bud like structures multicellular green bud like structure, they are that asexual buds. So they are known as that jamma cups. They are known as the jamma. So these jammas are present in receptacle. Jammas are present in receptacles. So these receptacles are known as that jamma cups. They are having that jammas. Multicellular green asexual buds are known as the jamma. Okay. So they are present in the receptacle. They are known as that jamma cups. Right. So at the time of favorable condition, these jammas are separated from the plant and falls on the soil, they are producing of that new plant. It means they are participate in vegetative reproduction process, right? After that, so sexual reproduction is takes place by that fission of gametes. Okay, so it is a zygogamous type of oogamy. Male gametes are released from that male plant. So generally these male gametes are considered as okay anthrozoids. So this anthrozoids are released from that antheridia. So then these male gametes are swim in the water and reach to the egg cell of archegonia. Okay, after reaching of that archegonia, so then by the fission of zygote, it is converted into that embryo. Then embryo is differentiated into that sporophyte. So that is that diploid multicellular structure is known as that sporophyte. So this sporophyte is differentiated. So the food seta and capsule, generally food seta is absent. Generally only what is a present, capsule is present in Markensia. So in that capsule, then the sporophyte producing spores from that spore mother cell undergoes meiotic division. Okay, so then these spores are again germinate to producing dominant gametophyte stage. So that is involvement of that bryophytes and liverworts. For the dispersal of spores, from sporophyte or from capsule, elaters are involved. Elaters are help. Okay, what is the meaning of elaters? Elaters are spiral thickenings and hair like structures known as that elaters. Okay, these elaters are formed from spore mother cells. Okay, so all spore mother cell they do not participate in meiosis. In some spore mother cells are converted into that. Okay, so multicellular and so it means spiral hair like structures known as the elaters, they are helped for dispersal of spores from the capsule. Okay, right. So that is known as that Markensia. So it is known as that archegoniophore. It is a female. So it is at arm 3 or 4, it is at a male. It is a dorsiventrally differential, these are the rhizoids. So these are that jamma cups, right? So that is known as that hepatic opsida, about that Markensia. After that Markensia, Anthoceratopsida. Anthoceratopsida, it is example for that Anthoceras. Anthoceras is generally known as that hornwort. Okay, hornworts. So it is also appear just like the thallus plant body. Thallus plant body like structures, but they are producing of that horn like structures. So that is known as that sporophyte. Okay, in that Anthoceras it is known as hornworts. It means our fertilization, so they are producing of that sporophyte. In this sporophyte is differentiated into that three parts. So generally foot. So instead of the seta, intercalary meristem. It is that objective bit. Intercalary meristem. Above that, capsule. Right? So sporophyte is differentiated of fertilization. So then it is producing three parts. So below that foot, at the middle, generally seta, instead of seta, it producing of that intercalary meristem. Due to the continuous growth of the intercalary meristem from the capsule, then it will protrude outside just like the horn-like structures. So these horn-like structures are formed by continuous growth of indefinite growth of that intercalary meristem. That's why they are known as that hornworts. So remaining all the structure are similar to that Markensia. Okay, so after that capsule, so in that capsule having that spore mother cells, so this spore mother cell undergoes meiotic division producing spores, right? For the dispersal of spores in capsule, so some spore mother cells are converted into that pseudo elaters. Okay, so they are helped for the dispersal of spores. Pseudo elaters use for dispersal of spores. From capsule. Okay, pseudo elaters means what are that? Elaters means spiral thickenings, hair-like structures. So in the pseudo elaters means, so generally they are also having that hair-like structures, but spiral thickenings are absent. They appear just like the elaters, but they do not having that spiral thickenings. That's why they are referred as pseudo elaters. So they are dispersal of spores from that capsule, right? So that is known as that hornwort. Okay, so these are the rhizoids. Hornwort or Anthoceras is attached to that soil or substratum by the presence of rhizoids. It is also dorsiventrally differentiated process.